Hi, Carsten, how are you?
Hi, Shaila. I'm fine. And you hope so?
Yeah, I'm very, thank you so much. And I'm very happy that finally we could schedule such an interview with you as well. So please tell me, do you live in Germany?
Yes, I live in Germany in Ilsede. That's in Lower Saxony, in the middle of Germany. The best place, of course.
You're an FDM therapist and you're also an FDM instructor. How much do you do of these activities?
For me, I make not so really the difference between instructing and between using. FDM is my life. And if I go out to the FDM courses, I explain from my work in the clinic. And in the clinic, I just do my hands-on from the FDM, because I don't make so much differences. The FDM came really from my heart, you know, and that's what I want to give to my patients and to the audience around the world.
Do you think your friends, your family understand what you're doing?
Oh, yes, I think so. Every day, they feel and they see what I will do, because it's not to make separately with my family, and the FDM is in the family, you know?
I hear from a lot of FDM therapists and also instructors that they kind of can't stop FDM coming out of them.
It's really right, because for me, FDM was a game changer. It was a turning point after school. I wanted to be a civil engineer, buildings, planning, and streets. That was my first opinion of my job. But I had great luck. In 2006, I met Dr. Gerhard Karrer from Wien. And that was a turning point for me. Before, I was working at normal osteopathic treatments. I worked with people like Jean-Pierre Barral, Alain Croibier, and the list goes on and on. And when I met Georg the first time and hearing talking about the FDM, I stopped and said, that is what I really need, where I've been looking for some years, but I've never found. But in this moment, I was very lucky that it was in the room where Georg was talking. And that was my start for FDM.
And I guess now you're also such a start for many people, because you're also an instructor. Where do you typically do your courses?
Do them in Germany, Munich, Hamburg, Berlin, in Switzerland, Zurich. We are going to Turkey this year and want to start the courses in Istanbul. And I hope so that in the future I can start in Italy, because Italy is one of my favorite areas.
What do you think FDM needs the most right now?
Everyone is talking about base evidence medicine. I don't really know.
Evidence-based. Mm-hmm.
I really don't know if that will solve the problems, because I think that FDM needs to become more popular, and we have to organize the courses more strictly, so that we have a normal level and everyone knows what is during the levels. You know, we have to be quite in the level. We are a practitioner. I am this, yes. And I don't know if the evidence-based medicine makes that FDM better. Some people always talk about, and they ask me in the courses, yes, I see what you have done, but please show me where I can read the studies and the based evidence medicine. Please show me. And I think that is a problem in the medicine, in my opinion, worldwide. Because I work like this, everything what I see, when it works, for me, is it okay? Yes, For me only, I'm looking for the facts and results.
If I can help you, for me, that's an evidence. I mean, what else do you need as a patient? Don't you want your problem to go away? And if it's gone, then isn't it enough proof for you? But yeah, of course, I understand that these two things are not the same, unfortunately.
So was the first time when I saw Gia Kara. What I've seen, the result was 100%. What should I have more?
You say that it would be important that more and more people get to know FDM. Do you have an idea how we could do that?
I think the best way is what we now at this moment are doing with these interviews, for example. I think that should be for the people important that they hear about and they hear some facts about that. And then everybody who wants to know more, he maybe goes to our courses. And there are some interesting books we have written, I think, for everyone who wants to know more. There's enough stuff to read it, yeah? And videos. I think that should be the first step.
So let's say there is a physiotherapist, there is a doctor who never heard about FDM. How would you describe FDM to such a person?
I tell the people that is important in the FDM. We listen to the patient, and during the listening, we look the body language, and after that we make examination, yeah? At the end, we got our distortion, one of the six or maybe some more. And that is the different to the normal medicine concept. In the other medicine, they make radiology and some pictures, for example, or X-ray, and then the doctor tells the patient what his problem is. In the FDM, we come together with the patient and we just in our clinic can do the examination, look for the body language and hear what he's talking. And that is so easy.
I also think that it's very important and it's stunning how easy FDM is and how close we can get to the patient only by watching and observing and truly listening to the patient. And many of them tell, I guess, to all of us, oh my God, I'm so thankful. You're the first person who is listening to me. If we are already talking about patients, can you please share a story with me about a patient who was special to you?
I think that every patient is special, but I remember one patient very well. It was long years ago. I was in the first months of working with FDM, and the people came in my ordination with lower back pain. And he taught me that the pain is years ago, and he had a lot of X-rays and a lot of therapists have been working on his problem. But there was no chance to stop the pain and he didn't know where can I go now. And it was a great success for him that he really came in my ordination and I was always in contact with the FDM and I know, maybe I look from my view to these people. And so I started how we always do. What is the problem? Why you come to me in my ordination? And then he started. And during the speaking, he had his body language. And so at the end, it was only lower back pain and not everything all. He had a list and the list goes on and on what his problem should be. But he said, yes, everything what I've done, there was no success. And after that all, we had two trigger bands. I started, and at the end, he can't believe because he was so easy to make motion, yes? And the pain, He said it was a little pain on the skin, but I think it's from your treatment, he told me, yes. But the normal pain, what I have for 4 years and more, it's away. He was a little, I don't know, he was a little upset because he can't realize what was happening. And he told me that this was the last chance for him because the employee talked to him, if you have sometimes longer this lower back pain, you have to stay at home and don't return back to your work. So he was in a little problem, and that's why he was so glad that somebody listened to his problems. And that was the first time he said me he was understand by a therapist. That's a story I don't forget, because these people came every time to me when he has problems, and he always remember the first contact. It's like a friendship, he told me.
That's so awesome. I think this is a very, very valuable gift from FDM, which I guess all of us feel like we all have that special patient, typically at the beginning of our career, which really touches us and just gives us this kind of proof that FDM works, and it works very well, and it works also with patients who already lost hope.
That's really true. It's the best gift I had earned. It's the FDM by Stephen Tupalos. And I'm so glad that I was in the course of Georg, because I explained it was a really game changer. Fantastic.
How many minutes do you smile a day?
10.
Are you a hunter or a gatherer?
No, I'm a hunter.
What do you think about when you're alone in your car?
I listen to my motto in the back, and I think it sounds great.
Texting or talking?
Talking.
What's your dream sandwich like?
Dream sandwich? I don't eat sandwiches.
Have you ever worn socks with sandals?
Never.
Awesome. Is there something you want to share with the people who are listening to this interview?
Yes, of course. It was a great time with you to do this interview and to keep your smile. And I tell you, I don't just smile 10 minutes a day. It was a joke. Smiling is all right, all the time.
Thank you so much for coming. It was very nice talking to you. And I hope a lot of people will listen to this interview and get to know you a little bit more. Thank you again, and I'll talk to you later.
Thank you so much, Shaila. Bye-bye. Greetings.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Ciao.